Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's another Tuesday. My name is Bernard Adiakwa from the Powerhouse Ministries International, and I'm coming your way with the spoken word of God. Over the past few weeks, we have been speaking about faith, and we keep looking at the details, the processes, and the techniques of igniting our faith so we can move mountains. Today, I'm going to be talking about the art of believing, and I shall focus primarily on believing and seeing. Faith is the force of life that gives you victory during life's trials and challenges. So in 1 John chapter 5, verse 4, the Bible says that, "For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith." So in spite of the challenges, in spite of the trials of life, God doesn't take them away, but he equips you as a victor to be able to live through these trials. And how do you do that? With our faith. Faith must be born of God. Anything that is born of God overcometh the world. So we are talking about a process that goes through birth, right through to travail and giving birth. It's a process from an initial meeting to intimacy, to lovemaking, nakedness, where the word of God enters into your life. You are not just around the word of God, but the entrance of the word of God giveth light. Into an incubation period and a period of pregnancy that takes a while before delivery. So you can see a process from initiation right through to delivery, and that is what faith is. Faith is not conjured overnight. Faith is a process that goes through various stages. The Bible tells us that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. If faith comes, then faith can also go. So when faith comes, there's a way you must keep it so that it can grow with you and it can benefit you. We learn from the book of Acts chapter 17, verse 11, how the people of Berea kept their faith and they grew it. It says that these were more noble than those in Thessalonica, in that when they heard the word of God, they received it with readiness of mind and searched the scriptures daily. The effect of their actions is found in verse 12. Therefore, many of them believed. So from the process of hearing the word into a process of entrenching your belief system so that you can ignite your faith is not an overnight miracle. It takes a process of searching the word of God daily, whether those things were so. These belief systems didn't take a day. From what they heard to what they believed was going to be a process. Number one, you receive the word of God with all readiness of mind. Number two, you search the scriptures daily. And as a result of that, then they believe. Jesus said, "And when you speak the word, you shall not doubt in your heart." So when the word of God comes into your life, one of the things it has to do is to remove the doubts concerning the promise of God in your life. So God's word concerning healing comes into your life, concerning prosperity comes into your life. There is doubt in your heart. Looking at your background, looking at your current situation, that word of God comes to move doubt away. How do you move doubt away? By searching the scriptures daily. The more you search the scriptures, the more you remove doubt. You remove anything that fights the word of God. You are daily pondering, analyzing, and comparing the word of God with your old belief system till you are convinced. And because the entrance of the word of God gives light, it gradually pushes darkness away from your life, and the light of God can shine into your heart. Against all contrary belief systems, the word of God will uproot the strongholds of negative thoughts and doubts in your life and create a power of imagination that breaks and overhauls your negative thinking. A new belief system will now be created. You begin to now envisage and see by the light of God what is possible. So you were in a dark room of sickness. The word of God says Jesus Christ healed you. What is going to remove the doubt, what God has said? It becomes a light that pushes the darkness out of your life. And the more you keep searching the scriptures, you entrench the word of God in your life. After a while, that light begins to shine in every part of your life, creating new pictures of healing and health and a better life for you. It is with that word that you are going to speak, and you keep saying it. So faith is going to go through a process. Your hearing, your studying the word, your meditation, and then your speaking the word of God. So let's quickly come back to Mark chapter 11, verse 22. And Jesus answering saith unto them, have faith in God. He's now going to explain the process. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say, let's analyze the scripture. Jesus starts by saying, have faith in God. But in the next verse, he shifts from faith in God to the individual who is now going to speak. So there's going to be a shift from what God has said into what you say. The onus is no longer on God. The onus is now falling upon you. There's a shift in the power system. When God created the earth, he said, let them have dominion, which means that he was taking the dominion from himself and giving it to man. Man is now going to stand in a position where you are going to exercise that authority over creation. So there's a shift from what God has said into what you now say. That is going to be formed or premised upon a belief system which was founded upon the written word you studied. This is very important. Faith cannot be conjured overnight. Faith cannot be faked. You've got to go through the process of searching the scriptures. Let the light of God enter into you and you form your own belief system. So it is no longer what God has said. It is no longer what your pastor has said. You are not just repeating from another person's statement, but you are now going to speak. And your speaking is going to be premised upon a belief system, upon the word. So there's a shift from God to you. The creation is now waiting to hear your voice. So Jesus noticed this and he says, now whosoever shall say to the mountain, it is not God who is speaking now, it is you. Whosoever shall say to the mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea. Again, we come back to a statement that is being said. It is not a Bible verse that is being quoted. The statement you are making has a foundation of a belief system on the word of God. But now you are speaking. You are no longer quoting. You are demanding, you are placing a demand on creation to conform to your word as a king and as a priest of the Most High. Be thou removed and be cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart. You have moved away from a position of doubt, because the light of God's word, as you meditated daily, has pushed away the doubt out of your life. You now believe against hope that there is healing. You now believe against circumstances of life that we will make it. You now believe against contrary statements on the news or reporters or evil winds that are blowing against you that you are above only. And every doubt has been removed. That's a fight. That's a process. That takes a while for it to be settled, of removing doubt. And shall not doubt in his heart. And I like the last part. And today I just end with that. But shall believe that those things which he saith, not what another person has said, not what God is saying now, but that which you say shall come to pass, you shall have what you say. In believing, it means you have gone beyond what a third party has said. You are now holding on to what you heard from God. There's a shift now from the speaker to the hearer. You came to church, the pastor preached, faith came. But now you believe it yourself. It is no longer third party report. Now you believe it, you identify with what you heard. It is now your word. It is now you speaking in the position of God on this earth. You are now representing God as an ambassador. You are now taking your position as a king, and you are going to decree a thing and it shall be established. The Bible tells all of us that we are healed by the stripes of Jesus. We have searched the scriptures. We have meditated on it. We have pushed doubt out of our lives. Now we stand and we can declare, I am healed. Wherever you are, I'm urging you to practice believing. Believing must be practiced. And the more you practice it, the stronger it becomes. So when you stand and face life storms, you can tell the waves and the storms to be still. And you believe it. Every miracle comes out of the spoken word, not the written word. Because there must be somebody who believes it and who will speak it forth. By faith, we move mountains. Continue speaking into your future. Continue speaking into your family. Speak to your body. Speak into your business. It shall come to pass. Because that's the year of the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.